Hi, welcome to week 7 of Magoos Corner. I'm your host, Trevor Gregg, joined by Damien Leonard from the Portland Footy Club. Hi, mate.
Hey, Trev, how are you?
Very good, thank you, sir. Now, we're going through the reserves competition, so looking at Div 4 reserves. So looking at the ladder quickly, we've got the two powerhouses, all three at the minute, which is Salisbury, undefeated at the moment, and on a nice percentage of 76. North Haven, the ones where I bought all of my premiership clothing from. I bought North Haven premiership jocks.
Yep.
They're 6-1. Hope Valley also on 6-1, and Kenilworth and Paraka dropping out of 5.
Pretty close. Notice that both North Haven and Hope Valley 81.2 and 81.22% as opposed to Salisbury sitting undefeated at 75.9. Shows that maybe Salisbury might have been lucky to get over. I know they've played North Haven. I'm not sure if they've played Hope Valley yet, but I suppose it's more important to get the 2 points and get a big win, but it'll be crucial come the second round, time round, who will finish top. So yeah. Havens, Hope Valley are looking like a chance, and can Salisbury hold on? So, and even the fifth spot's going to come down to the wire with Westminster and Parker fighting it out with eight or four wins each. So
yeah, and then you've got Hectorville, Glenunga sitting on Hectorville with 2 wins, Glenunga with 1, and unfortunately Eastern Park and Kilburn also winless at the moment. So Kilburn still fronting up, still doing what they need to do. Yeah. I think that with their win, with the possibility of a win last week, but they were much more competitive. But 916 against and only 173.4, so it's been a tough year for them, and we know what it's like. But
yeah, no, you've got to put their tip your hat to them, the fact that they keep fronting up when I suppose they know they're going to be on the end of a shaking. Mm. But their first game of the round, Kilburn lost to Glenunga 7-4-46 to 11-15-81. Could have been a bit more of a blowout had Glenunga kicked straight, but still a good effort or a better effort on Kilburn's behalf. So best for Kilburn were Colson, Kyres, Austin, Broadhead and Perkins, with Owen, Smith, Wheeler, Brummer, Chenoweth, Austin and old A. Laslett chipping in with a goal apiece. And best for Glenunga, we had Simper, Pilgrim Lynch, Alexander, Lagernestra and Edwards. So I'm pretty happy with how I pronounced that. Cicluna, the old Maltese, kicking in 2. Bowsy with 2. Simper with 2. Carbalus, 2. Alexander, Lagernestra, I've probably said it wrong this time, and Spencer kicking some goals for Glenunga. So
much more of a better show for Kilburn and the twos this week. So good on you, lads, and hopefully you can do something a little bit better next week. Haven't seen who you got, but we'll have a look. Which by the looks of it, it'll be the same story. But moving on to the next one, it was North Haven taking on Eastern Park at home for the Havens, and it was 27-19, 181, 4-2, 26. So North Haven getting the job done, plenty.
Yeah, so old Burnsy chipping in with not only getting best on but kicking 6, so it's fair to say he's been on fire of late. Had a gig in the ones last week, and obviously he had a few return from injury, and he's back in the twos and pushing for a spot again. So hopefully he can just get out of that crash that he's back in the twos and get back in the ones. So Ty Durden with 3, so he's just plodding along there. Keros with 3, Damon McCulloch with 3, H. Corey with 3, old Albatross Lipson with 2, Zachy Phillips with 2, Luke Gill, usually plays centre half back, so slotting with a goal, Musha Davidson, old Dangy Britton, and Caelan Butler with 1 apiece. So, and best, like I said, old Burnsy was best on with Brain, Butler, Musha and Corey for the best for Havens. So
for Easter Park, we had Cullen, Ryan, Aegis and King with the goal scorers, Prime, Brooks, Page, Siri and Edwards. So yeah, I was a bit surprised to see that one come through with Moose to go down there, but good.
He's got friends out there. I thought it was a chance to come and have a kick with his brother, but hopefully he's enjoying his footy, and
has he kicked David out? David's usually kicked a bag.
Yeah, I've got a feeling Trent would probably be playing more in a forward pocket, swapping on the ball, I would have thought, but I'm not too sure. I haven't spoke to Andy or anything about where he played in the ones, so Damon would still be 4-4, I'd assume. Mm.
The next game, we had Paraka taking on Hectorville at Limblock Park. It was 9-14-68 for the Bulls, 6-5-41 for Hectorville, which is another one where they don't have the results in. So I know it can be difficult running around trying to do everything on the day, and I've been a victim of it when you've had your team manager call in sick or whatever, but there's really no excuse not to get your team sheets in.
Yeah, no, it's just frustrating really. So, but what we do have is Parakas, goal scorers and best players. So you've got Turner with 3, Didak with 2, Trent Berth with 1, Romeo Nudo, and old Dallas Wild in the with 1. So best players were Edwards, Nitschke, Chisholm, Clark, Romeo and Hutchings. So I noticed Didak, he was one that we played against many years ago in the Bees and still kicking around, so good on him. Yeah. So
Still been around for a long time. Now moving on to the next game, which was Kenilworth. Kookaburra is taking on Westminster Old Scollegians. That's a STD, isn't it? It's 13-15-93 to 7-3-45. Kenilworth, goal scorers was Delaware with 2, Roberts with 2, Hoffmeyer with 2, and it looks like they're fairly good spread.
I just want to have a crack at that one.
Hoffmeyer?
No, the one.
Oh, Diamondopoulos.
Yeah, that's what we're
talking about. Diamondopoulos. Or the Diamond. We'll just call him the Diamond for future reference. Hendry, Hoffmeyer, Sheldrick, Delaware, and Crouch getting in the best players. For Westminster, it was Harris, Caldwell with 2 apiece, Ryan, McKendrick, Williams, goal scorers, and for best players was Harris, Lloyd, Williams, Ryan, and Heen. So, not a bad turn up for the Kookaburras, and a nice result in the end.
Yeah, they'd be happy with that, I would have thought. So, at home, big oval, they obviously played reasonably well. And Westminster is another small oval, so maybe they don't like the bigger ovals.
And that was quite a good win for Kenilworth, considering where they are on the ladder, so it gives them a little bit of breathing space. Moving on to the next one, the last game of the round, which was Salisbury and Hope Valley at a Salisbury Oval. 13-13-91 to Hope Valley 6-4-40, so very good for Salisbury.
Yeah, excellent win. So at home, we were just saying that Hope Valley and North Haven pushing for that top spot, but off the back of this result, we're possibly maybe it's a two-horse race with Salisbury and North Haven. So best players were for Salisbury, we had Atkinson, Zappler, Smith, Herman and Catford, and Caruso, Atkinson, Druitt, Marks, Russo, Herman, Kuzner, Druitt and Catford chipping in for some goals. So, and in Hope Valleys we got Staunton, Slater, White, Glenn and Arts for the best players. Finlay kicking 2, Glenn, Vozzo, Staunton and Moran chipping in with 1 apiece. So Hope Valley would be pretty disappointed with that, I would have thought. I'd hope they think they're an opportunity to win the flag and to get done by 9 or 8 goals by the top side when you sit in third. They'd be pretty disappointed with that.
Yeah, and I think it was where Salisbury, I think it was their 18s that actually forfeited last week.
Okay.
So they're doing okay in the ones from memory, but unfortunately not doing
second in the ones. So
moving on to round 8. At Daly Oval, we have Hectorville taking on North Haven.
Yeah, North Haven are comfortable to get the win.
I think so. Eastern Park taking on Glenunder at Dwight Reserve.
This is going to be a close one. I reckon Eastern Park may get over at home with a bit of the old intimidation over the boys from the from Glen Osmond Road.
Yeah, too long a drive. Westminster taking on Salisbury, Glendore Oval.
Yeah, Salisbury will be looking to continue on with an unbeaten run. That's the word I was looking for.
Yep, so I think Salisbury will also get the job done. Hope Valley take on Parakka.
Hope Valley are going to bounce back, you would have thought. So they'll be looking for some blood.
Yep, I definitely think that Hope Valley will get there quite easily. And Kenilworth take on Kilburn.
Yeah, Kenilworth to get the win comfortably there. But good luck to Kilburn. Hopefully they can be a bit more competitive like they showed they were last week by the looks of it.
Onwards and upwards for Kilburn. So good luck, lads. So that's week 7 of the Division 4 Reserves review and preview. We'll catch you again next week, but make sure you subscribe to the SA Footballer magazine, and we'll catch you again.